Hey guys, you might have seen body fat scale videos where someone just unboxes them, tries them once, and gives their opinion. That's not what I'm about, so in this video you will see a detailed comparison of muscle, bone, fat, and water across 12 weeks of data from myself and my wife, as well as the readings they gave immediately after I had a DEXA scan, said to be the gold standard for measuring body composition. The scales in question are the Tanita BC543, Omron Viva, Withings Body Smart, Runstar Smart, and the Renfo LS1 Smart Scales. So everything's going to fail miserably if they can't agree on the primary metric that we want from a scale, our weight. Thankfully, there is a nice alignment here from both myself and my wife's data. We did find that most discrepancies were down to user error, electronic scales need to calibrate and zero themselves, and pausing before stepping on them is enough to avoid this mistake. They aren't perfectly aligned. Renfo consistently gave my wife her highest weight and Withings the lightest, with a difference of around 250 grams, which is half a pound. The same was true for my values, but slightly less at 200 grams. Next, I'm going to show you a metric called total body water, and that's because hydration status is really key to accurate measurements. Bioelectrical impedance scales, which is what these are, work by sending a small electrical current through the electrodes under your feet, which pass up and down your legs without you noticing. Due to the different speeds that it travels through muscle, fat, and bone, it can then estimate your body composition. The current travels faster through muscle, but it also travels faster the more hydrated you are. So if you're really hydrated, it's going to assign a greater percentage to your muscle mass and a lower percentage to body fat. That's why the instructions tell you to avoid measuring straight after eating or exercising, as those activities can change your hydration status. Despite being very consistent with time of day and clothing, we both experienced natural fluctuations in our total body water. Now, the Omron scales don't report total body water, so we're left with four scales. Tanita and Withings are very well aligned, while Runstar and Renfo report a much higher value. You'll also notice that fluctuations in the lower two aren't mirrored in the other scales. That becomes much more obvious when we switch to my graph. I had two spikes in my Tanita and Withings, which weren't seen in Runstar or Renfo. And in fact, the highest water percentage for Runstar and Renfo was on the same day as Tanita and Withings' lowest. Having previously been weighing myself 3 hours after breakfast, the anomaly here coincided with my DEXA scan, which was taken at 9 a.m. on an empty stomach. I was quite frustrated that it was so different from my other readings because, as you'll see later on, it skews the value for muscle and body fat. So is it possible to correct for hydration? I weighed myself on two consecutive mornings. The first, I was deliberately hydrated, and the second time, I had dehydrated myself. Tanita and Withings picked this up, and I had over 1% difference in total body water for those days. As expected, they both reported an increase in body fat with dehydration and a decrease in muscle mass. We could therefore correct for this relationship by factoring in total body water when we're looking at muscle and fat scores. The only thing to note is that genuine changes in body composition will result in a change in total body water because muscle has a higher water content than fat. This is most obvious when you look at my wife's data from 5 years ago. She was 10 kilos lighter and consistently reporting 6% higher total body water on my Tanita scales. So as long as you're adjusting to a recent average for your total body water, you should be able to correct for any major fluctuations, but if you are seeing them, a better approach would just be to discard the data and weigh yourself the next day. Okay, onto the main event. Now that we understand the effect that hydration has on the readings, you can appreciate any spikes you see in the next few graphs. First up, my wife, she was weighing herself first thing in the morning and seemed to have more consistent hydration. Despite agreeing on total body water, Tanita and Withings are vastly different when it comes to body fat, with Tanita the least flattering, averaging 37.5% fat, Withings down at 29.5%, and Runstar even lower at 27.5%. She didn't have a DEXA scan, so I can only go by online body fat images, where I would say she's slightly north of 30%, meaning the average of all these readings may be closest to the truth. Before showing my body fat, I want to quickly jump back to my body mass graph to highlight my time with norovirus, the winter vomiting bug, which saw me average fewer than 1,000 calories a day between the 4th and 10th of December. I lost around 3 kilos, 6.5 pounds in the process. If we now move to my body fat graph, you can see that the magnitude of body fat change differs by scale, but they all agree that I'm a lower percentage fat following the virus. Tanita mirrors Withings quite nicely, while Omron matches the ups and downs of both Runstar and Renfo, except that it's 2 to 3% higher. You can see why I was so frustrated about the readings on the 18th, because that was my DEXA scan measuring on an empty stomach, and it's so different to my other readings. In hindsight, it would have been better to do all my readings before breakfast, knowing that at some point I was going to compare them to a DEXA scan. For those not familiar, a DEXA scan is a type of X-ray. There is one specifically for measuring bone density, but I had the one for body composition. Any recent food in my system would skew the results, which is why I had to skip breakfast prior to the scan. It's a case of lying perfectly still for several minutes. Results are available straight away, and it costs around £100 and £150 to have this done. Straight after the scan, I measured with all five sets of scales, which produced the following results. Rather surprisingly, since DEXA is said to be the gold standard, it had my body fat at 8.8%, but with my total body water right up at 66% and some of my highest hydration readings on all the other scales, I felt this was underreporting my fat mass. However, we can still compare to the scale measurements, which ranged from 12.8 to 16.5% fat. What that means is none of the scales are reporting values close to my DEXA scan. I've heard the argument that having an uneven fat distribution could cause this, for example, if I carry proportionately more fat in my legs, but the segmental analysis showed only small differences between my arms, legs, and torso. So where does that leave us? Ultimately, if we're using these body fat scales to track changes in body composition, it doesn't really matter what the starting number is. All that matters is that as we gain or lose fat, it correctly reports that. In other words, it's directionally accurate. From that perspective, they all picked up the changes to my body composition after illness. The differences did range from Omron at 1.8% down to Tanita and Withings at 1%, with Runstar and Renfo in the middle at 1.2%. Knowing the relationship between total body water, we can now apply a correction factor to body fat. Without overcomplicating it, I'm simply going to adjust my body fat up 0.1% for every 0.1% my total body water is above the recent average. So if I averaged 58% water in recent weeks and it then reports 58.5%, I'll adjust my body fat up by 0.5%. This gives a much cleaner picture of body fat changes, and you can see all of them picking up the dramatic single week change in early December. So the other side of the equation is muscle mass, which is subject to the same fluctuations from hydration status, but in the opposite direction. So the dips from Withings and Tanita now become peaks. Interestingly, it seems like Omron behaves more like Tanita and Withings when it comes to muscle mass, and Runstar and Renfo for body fat. What's also obvious is that the scales report very different numbers to each other. That's mostly explained by the fact that some are reporting total muscle mass, while others are reporting skeletal muscle mass. There are smooth muscles around your organs, and total muscle is closer to body mass minus fat mass minus bone mass. Taking the scales that only report total muscle mass, they're really well aligned, and in this zoomed in view, it's clearer to see the 2 days on which I was very hydrated. Runstar and Renfo report both skeletal and total muscle mass, so I've added them in here and they're also well aligned. Moving across to skeletal muscle mass, again, Runstar and Renfo are almost identical, while Omron is the outlier, down at 37% skeletal muscle with the two hydration spikes. My DEXA scan reported skeletal muscle at 45%, so Omron is closer, but none of them seem that accurate. My wife sees more of a separation between Withings and Tanita, and as she didn't do a DEXA scan, there's no way of knowing which is more accurate. For total muscle mass, three scales are generally aligned, and Tanita stands out with its lower value. The last metric I want to quickly cover is bone mass. This was reported by my DEXA scan at 2.8 kilos, which aligned really nicely with what my scales have been reporting. Many of them round to the nearest 100 grams, so when the figure changes, it looks more dramatic on the zoomed in graph. It's important to note that bone mass is not the same as bone density. Without knowing the area of your bones, you can't judge your risk of things like osteoporosis. However, an expert on a podcast said that for an individual, the bone mass trend could be useful information. Before you get too excited about how close they all were to my DEXA scan results, we need to look at Evelina's graph. This is all over the place, with the extremes differing by almost a full kilogram, so their alignment seems to vary based on the individual. We saw quite a few correlations there, that is, pairs of measurements that seem to move in sync with each other, and I've created this table based on my readings to highlight a few. Here, a strong correlation is dark green, moderate is light green, and weak is white. The most obvious correlation would be that for the same set of scales, you'd expect a really strong relationship between muscle, water, and fat. Weirdly, that's not true for Omron. There's quite a weak relationship between skeletal muscle and body fat percentage. That's because they seem to be using two different algorithms. So skeletal muscle correlated really well with the values reported by Tanita and Withings, while body fat correlates with Runstar and Renfo. You can see that Tanita and Withings are very similar, as are Runstar and Renfo, and the lowest correlations are found with the total body water from Tanita or Withings and the Runstar and Renfo scales. So with all that said, which scale is the best? I'm not really sure, but what I would say is that total body water is such a key metric for interpreting your results that I would have to rule out the Omron. Those are the only scales that don't report it. Runstar and Renfo are very similar and may well use the same algorithm. They also report a lot of other metrics like subcutaneous and visceral fat, protein content, and metabolic age, though I'm not sure how reliable those are. I've had my Tanita scales for almost 6 years now, and I think it's time to retire them. My motivation for doing this was that I didn't feel it was reacting enough to changes in my body composition. What I also realized over the 12 weeks is how tedious it was to keep track of historical data. They don't have an app, so I've been scribbling down the readings on a post-it note and adding them into a spreadsheet, whereas with the others, you just step on and go. Withings are a good option. I do find it a little unnerving that deliberate attempts to change my hydration status weren't picked up by Renfo and Runstar, so I'm happier with Withings' interpretation of total body water. A negative for Withings is the price. I purchased these for £90 and I picked up the Renfo scales for £24. Omron were £70. Runstar's retail for £40 if they're new, and Tanita may not even produce the model I own anymore. There are other factors to consider, like integration with other apps, but the focus of this video was on the accuracy of the readings. I hope you found this video useful. I certainly learned a lot from doing the analysis and answering my own questions about which set of scales I should use going forward. Thanks for watching.